Hey everyone, it's the Ioniq guy. Today's video is one that's been a long time coming. You've probably heard in some of my other videos that I have had a rock chip right here on the hood of my Ioniq 5 for probably 6, maybe more months now. And it drives me crazy. It's in a very noticeable spot right there. Whenever you walk up to the car and you're coming from the front, you see it every single time. And it's down to the primer, so it's white underneath and it really sticks out. It's been driving me crazy. And I've been trying and trying and trying for the better part of 6 months to get a paint pen from Hyundai in Digital Teal. And I found that this color has been harder to find than other colors. So I tried again, placed an order on HyundaiShop.com, and lo and behold, I finally got it. I finally got M9U, which is the color code for Digital Teal. So this paint pen is nice because it does come with the obviously matching color on one side of the pen. But on the other side, you have clear coat. So all in one solution, you can put your color down and clear coat. And inside the box, they do also provide a little sanding stick, which has a nice fine point on it. So you can get into those areas and give it a little roughening up so that the paint will adhere a little bit better. So besides the touch-up pen itself and the sanding stick, the only other things you're gonna really need are some spray to clean the area, a microfiber. And whenever I touch up paint, I like to use isopropyl alcohol on a Q-tip and just clean out that area. This way there's no oil, there's no residue that's going to prevent the paint from adhering to the subsurface well. So we finally got a warm day. You can see here it's 56 degrees in my garage. And I've had the paint pen for a few weeks now, but it's been so damn cold that I haven't been able to apply it because you don't want to apply paint in cold weather. So there's no specification on what temperature you should wait to have until you use the touch-up pen, but I would say anywhere around 55 and higher, you'll probably be in good shape. So on the touch-up pen here, you can peel back the label and it gives you a nice set of detailed instructions on how to properly apply the touch-up paint. So you can go ahead and go through this when you actually get it. So we got the paint pen, I got all the tools together. Let's go ahead and do this. So the first thing I'm gonna do is spray the area with some detailer. And I'm just gonna give that a wipe just to knock off any road grime. And you wanna expose a new part of the microfiber every time you wipe it. This way you're not dragging grime and causing more scratches on the car. So that looks pretty good. I am seeing another really tiny paint chip right there and another one right there as well, but these ones are so small that that one I might be able to get, but this one I don't think I can. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the sanding stick and I'm just going to come in here and I'm just gonna rough up that chip a little bit just to make sure we get good adhesion. And that's probably all we really need. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some isopropyl alcohol and a Q-tip and I'm just going to clean up any bits of residue left over from sanding right there. I'm just gonna go ahead and dunk this into the bottle. And the reason I want to use a Q-tip with the isopropyl is because I can't remember the last time I waxed the car. So I don't want to take off whatever wax is around the area. So I want to go in and be able to control how much alcohol I'm putting down without just stripping this whole area of whatever wax is left on it. You just want to rotate the Q-tip as you go to kind of just scoop up those bits. That should be good. So we'll let that alcohol flash off. If you wave your hand onto that spot, it'll help the alcohol flash a little bit quicker. The next step in the instructions is to shake the pen for 30 seconds. So we'll go ahead and do that. So there's 30 seconds. So next you're going to need a small piece of cardboard. So the next step is to remove air in the tube by pointing the pen's color tip upward, pushing the tip downward using the cap. So we'll go ahead and pop the cap And your pen tip won't look like this. It won't have the color on it. I tested it on a piece of cardboard already just to see what the color looked like. So yours will be pure white here, but go ahead and hold the pen vertically, push down with the cap, and that should allow any air that's trapped inside to escape, eliminating hopefully any bubbles. So now what they say to do is to take a scrap piece of cardboard and just push down with the tip applicator until you get paint flow. Now, if you have a clean, unused tip, this is gonna take a little bit of time, but since mine was already saturated, you can see that I'm already getting paint onto the cardboard here. So my paint pen is ready to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and wipe off any excess paint from the tip so that we don't put too much on. So according to the instructions, lightly tap the pen's color tip on scratched or chipped area. Do not drag tip across. Apply second coat as needed. Wait 15 to 20 minutes between coats. Replace the cap when completed. If a tip dries out, remove it and dip in lacquer thinner. Put it back and replace cap. Okay, here we go. And you just want to go very lightly. You don't want to put too much paint on there. So just dabbing to make sure I get the whole chip. And I think I got most of it. Doesn't take a lot. And if it looks like you put down too much, you can just take a clean paper towel and kind of blot any really high spots you might see. But that already looks 100 times better than it did. At least it covered up the white primer underneath. So I'm gonna go ahead, put the cap back on. We'll set this aside, come back in 20 minutes and see how it looks. So it's been about 15 minutes now. The paint is completely dry to the touch. So we'll go ahead and do the clear coat now because it looks good enough that I don't think it needs another coat of color. So according to the instructions, we're gonna go ahead and repeat all the same steps we did with the color side for the clear coat. So we'll start out by shaking this for 30 seconds. Okay, there's 30 seconds. We will go ahead and release any air by pushing down on the tip of the pen. And now we'll go ahead and push down here until we get some flow. You know what, it actually felt like there was a seal that needed to be broken by pushing down just a little bit harder. So now the clear coat is flowing, you can see it right here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just try to remove as much as I can on the cardboard here. So that's looking good. Now we'll come in here and we'll just put a little dab. So again, you don't wanna drag the pen around, you just wanna dab it. So that looks like enough clear coat. I'll put the cap back on, you can put that away. But it is a little proud of the rest of the paint, so I'm just gonna go ahead and try and soak up a little bit. You just wanna try and smooth it out a little bit. It's not gonna be a perfect repair, but it at least prevents the car from rusting. So there it is, all finished. We'll give it 15, 20 minutes to cure, and then we'll come back and check on it. So it's been another 15, 20 minutes, and there is the repair right there. The video doesn't do it justice just because of the way the light's reflecting off of it. It looks significantly better than the deep scratch that was there before. So there you go, guys. That's how you can touch up your paint on any Hyundai, Kia, or Gensis product. The paint pens should be the same across the board. It's a pretty painless process. So by following the steps I showed you, you should get good paint adhesion and you shouldn't have issues with it flaking off or anything. It's never gonna be a perfect repair, but it will prevent rusting in the future. If you really go out of your way, you can spot it. But for most people that don't own the car and are just looking at it, they probably won't even notice. So anyway, guys, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care, everybody.